Today we're going to show you how to take circumference measurements, or measuring around the body. And Cristina, Professor Carrillo, has volunteered to be our client, so I can demonstrate on her. When you take the measurements, you can use like a regular dressmaker's tape measure. Oops. So we can use that. Or if you have an anthropometric tape measure that has a Gulick handle, as you pull that out, you're going to pull it to the little mark on the handle, and that will help create consistent tape tension. So we're going to kind of work down from the top of the body. The first measurement we're going to take is the neck measurement. You want to take that pretty much at the level of the Adam's apple, or where that would be. I think we're going to have you turn sideways. I'm going to wrap the tape measure around. As we overlap it, let me get a little bit better here. Want to be pretty much right below the Adam's apple, or where we would have that. The tape is not necessarily going to be horizontal. It's going to follow the curvature of the neck. This is the only measurement where we do not use the Gulick handle. We don't want to put excess tension there. So I'm just going to wrap it around. I've got the loose end of the tape on top. I can read right down 30.5 centimeters. Next measurement is going to be the waist measurement. We're going to take that at the narrowest part of the waist. So I'm going to take it either from the front or the back. I'm going to look for the narrowest part. Again, wrap the tape around. You need to make sure that it is level. So take a look, make sure it's not over any clothing. Again, when you pull out the Gulick handle to the point, you see where it overlaps, so that measurement is 65.5 centimeters. Then we're going to go to the abdomen. The abdomen, there are actually three abdominal measurements. First one is a standard abdominal. We're going to go around the level of the greatest anterior protrusion of the abdomen. So I can see that from the side. Going to go where I have the widest portion. Again, we wrap the tape around. This one will likely be over some clothing, so wear some loose-fitting clothing. Okay, as we wrap the tape, double-check it's over the widest portion. Pull out to the Gulick handle, and I can read my measurement, which is 75.4 centimeters. There is a second abdominal measurement, which is right at the level of the umbilicus, or the belly button. So that measurement, we're going to go right over the belly button. Going to get it off the clothing if I can. Level. Right over the belly button. I pull out the Gulick handle, and I am at 66.9 centimeters. There's a third abdominal measurement, which is kind of unusual. It's midway from the xiphoid process of the sternum to the umbilicus, or the belly button. So I need to measure and mark that. We're not going to eyeball it. We need to measure it. So you'll palpate the xiphoid process of the sternum. Going right down to the belly button, I have 16 centimeters, so I'm going to make a mark at 8 centimeters. I'm going to go right around that mark. So I want to go right over the mark with the tape measure, double check that it's level in the back. Oops, got caught up in there. And pull it out to the point on the Gulick handle, and you can take the measurement. Okay, now we're going to measure the hips and buttocks. For the hips and buttocks, you need the widest protuberance posteriorly over the gluteal muscle, so the widest point. So from the side, you can see where that is. We're going to wrap the tape measure around. Go right over the widest portion. If it's slipping on the clothing, and we do need light-fitting clothing for this, you can have the client just put her hand on the tape to hold it there. I'm going to double-check it's level. I'm going to pull it out to the mark on the Gula candle, and I have 95.5 centimeters. Okay, then we're going to do mid-thigh. For the mid-thigh, I need to measure the midpoint from the inguinal crease to the top proximal border of the patella. So she can either sit down so her leg is bent, or she can put it up on a stool. For all the limb measurements, the standard method is to measure the right side of the body. It does not matter if they're left or right-handed. We're going to measure the right side. Going to measure from the inguinal crease, right at the crease of her leg, up to the top of the patella, proximal border of the patella. I get 38 centimeters, so I'm going to make a mark at 19 midway. Then when we take the measurement, her foot comes off the stool or she stands up if she's seated. Going to go right around that mark. I want to go right over the mark. Once again, make sure it's level. And I pull out, let's get to the point on the Gula candle. Next, we're going to go to the knee measurement. We're going to measure right around the middle of the patella. Again, right side of the body. Knee can be just slightly bent. Palpate, find the middle of the patella. Wrap the tape around, and you can take your measurement. I'll move it a little bit more that way. Okay, next is the calf measurement. For the calf measurement, the person can either be standing with their weight evenly distributed, or they can be sitting down with their leg hanging freely. We're going to put Cristina up on a stool. You don't have to do that, but it makes it easier for me to take the measurement. I'm going to turn you to the side because we want to take the measurement at the widest position of the calf. So from the side, I can see that. Going to take the tape right around at the widest portion. Make sure it's level. Pull it out to the Gula candle. Or if you're using just a regular tape measure, try to consistently create tape tension. You want it taut, but you don't want to indent the skin. Okay, Cristina can step off. We'll get the stool out of the way. A measurement that we've added this year is the iliac circumference. It's used in one of the prediction equations for men. And this is going to be right over the top of the iliac crest, or right over the ASIS, anterior superior iliac spine. So we're going to need to palpate those. Going to wrap the tape measure around. Again, double check the location. This one, check. Make sure you don't have clothing caught in the back. Wrap it around and then take your measurement. Okay, we have two more measurements which are on the upper limb. We're going to do biceps and then the forearm. For the biceps measurement, we need to go midway from the acromion process to the olecranon process of the ulna. So I need to palpate those two points. I want to measure on the side of the arm. So I've got 36 centimeters, so halfway will be 18. I put my mark there. We're measuring on the side because if we have a bulging biceps or triceps, that's going to impact that measurement. So I want it as linear as possible. OK, Okay, once we have it marked, then we're going to put the tape measure right over the mark. Going to pull it out to the Gula candle, and then I can see my measurement. Okay, last measurement is the forearm. For the forearm, just going to let your arm hang freely, palm up. I want to measure around the maximum circumference, so that's going to be close to the elbow. Wrap the tape around the maximal circumference of the forearm, which is going to be close to the elbow. So, double check you have it located properly. Pull it out to the Gula candle, and then you can read that measurement. So that looks like it's pretty much exactly 22.0 centimeters. All right, so those are the measurement sites you want to do. Now, once I've done all those, and I didn't mention, but you take each measurement, you write it down on your data sheet, then we go back and do them all again. We won't demonstrate that again, but we're going to go through them again. If the two measurements are not close enough, you go back and do the third measurement. The reason why we do them in a rotational order is we want each measurement to be independent. So we don't want you to be impacted. If you remember a certain measurement, then there's a tendency to pull the tape to that measurement again. So go through all the measurements once, go back through and do them all again, deliberately trying to forget your measurements, and then you do a third trial for the measurements that you need.